Hi guys, here I am again. I'm going to make a chicken curry this time, and I have to tell you, for the past few weeks I've had nothing but South African, Cape Malay chicken curry on my mind, and I have no idea how to cook it, but I have my own version of chicken curry that I enjoy, and tonight I'm making an enhanced version inspired by that brinjal curry I just made. So what I've got here, I've got chicken thigh fillets that I've marinated in the juice of one lemon, lemon zest, ginger, garlic, and you know, my spices. I've used sumac as well, coriander, cumin, a bit of garam masala, and turmeric. 1 teaspoon of salt.
So
that has been marinating. I've got onions that are finally chopped up, my handheld blender, and 2 tomatoes. I've also got the desiccated coconut, which I'll be adding 2 tablespoons of, cumin and caraway seeds, which I'll go ahead and put straight in there. Cayenne pepper, chili pepper, and I'll try a bit of the tahini paste as well. Just a little bit. So, let me get started. Put the oil in there. Put in the chicken. Just gonna put in 1 teaspoon of sesame paste. I'm just going to spread it around so it can brown a little bit. And then I'll go straight into adding the onions for a couple of minutes, then the tomatoes, bit of water, and it couldn't be simpler than that. And I think the trick with this dish, well, in my kitchen at least, is this tool that I use. It's a gift that I got from a special friend for my wedding. It was a very, very generous gift, and I've had it for over 8 years, and it cooks me meals very quickly. Now I want the onion to have a bit more time cooking in there, just to get rid of the rawness and to add a bit of sweetness to the curry. So I'm going to give it about 5 minutes, you know, keep stirring. I've got it on a really high heat, so keep stirring and let it cook for about 5 minutes, then add the tomato, add boiling water, and allow to simmer for about 10 minutes, and that will be it. Added 2 tablespoons of desiccated coconut. Now I'm going to add in the tomato. Roll that around. Wash it down with a bit of water. Added about 3/4 of a cup of water there, and just reduce the heat, cover with a lid, and allow to simmer. Oh, and while I'm at it, chili flakes. Woo-hoo! I am just adding the whole lot. Okay, here we go. It's been about 10 minutes just to allow the chicken to cook and everything to reduce. Yeah. And it's looking lovely. The color is wonderful. Let's just take a closer look. I had actually done a taste test
just to check for salt and seasoning. And you know, I found that the lemon's great. It was slightly, you know, I didn't want it to be overpowering, so I put in a teaspoon of sugar just to try and balance it out. So
it's just about done.
And the taste test as usual.
Here we go. That's a very lovely curry. You know, it's got the coconut in, so it brings a lovely flavor, and you can taste the spices. All in all, it looks wonderful. I mean, just have a look at that. It's nice. It's got a wonderful thickness to it, and I'm just gonna put it in my plate and I'm going to enjoy the night. Bon appetit!